scream, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance, rest the speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly, when I play a dope melody. Anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it, you better gain weight. You better hit the bullseye, the kid don't play. And if there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
We have a hydrogen assist system, and what it does is we displace some of the gasoline that goes in the motor, and so we have a hydrogen gas that takes the place of the gasoline. So the hydrogen gas comes through the bottom of the grill shell. We have it capped off on the inside, and encapsulated we have a tube with holes drilled in it so that it disperses the bubbles evenly throughout the tubes. It comes in the top, and then another tube comes out and goes to the intake of the motor. I'm getting 60 miles per gallon with 1,200 horsepower.
60 miles per gallon, 1,200 horsepower, hydrogen rat rod.
Hydrogen rat rod. I think I can live with you saying that. It doesn't hurt too bad.
Hydrogen assist?
Hydrogen assist. I can run, I ain't going to let too much out the bag, but we've gotten some high numbers. The truth is, the hydrogen's always been out there since the 70s, and it's just been suppressed. It is a clean, alternative to taking and running gasoline on the hot rods.
Right.
What I'm trying to do is make sure that hot rods stay on the planet and that they don't get disbanded, you know, with all the new laws and whatnot. So if we can take and, change the way we think and just have a hydrogen assist, it's all it is water. That's all it is.
Right.
We don't have Mercedes and some other people have tried it, and they have these 3,000 PSI tanks in the trunk, and I'm like, that's a bomb. You know, if you got hit in the butt, it'd be like a Pinto, but, you know, magnified.
Okay, so there's hydrogen assist hidden somewhere in this car.
Hey, you're right, it is hidden.
And you're not going to tell us where it is.
Oh, no. No, I left a couple of the pieces off, in fact, just because I can't watch it night and day, you know, but this is like one of the generators right here. This is a hydrogen cell right here. And what hydrogen is basically you have water in a tube or a container of some sort. And when you deliver power to it, it basically, with the water, it separates the hydrogen atom. Hydrogen is a bigger explosive, but it's a direct element of what goes in your motor. It's clean. The emissions that come out your car are the cleanest emissions pools you can possibly find anywhere on the planet. You can drink the water that comes out the exhaust if you had a clean enough exhaust pipe, I guess. And it's an alternative. I mean, you know, you can get high fuel mileage. It's better on the motor. You don't have any carbon buildup to speak of on the inside of your motor, so you change your oil like every 8,000 miles instead of every 3, because there's no...
It's a real under-the-radar deal right here. People are walking by looking at this car. They have no friggin' clue that it's hydrogen assist, and it gets 60 miles to the gallon, 1,200 horsepower.
They're thinking 6 miles per gallon is what they're thinking.
That's amazing.
It is.
And you're selling these. You're actually manufacturing these and selling these. So somebody watching right now, if they wanted one,
not the hydrogen
they could
part.
Buy it from you for 45 grand, right?
Not this one for sure, and I can't sell the hydrogen system on them yet. I'm taking and making sure that it gets out there and it gets used in the right way. I mean, you can look online, just be real careful. I mean, there's a lot of things like on eBay and whatnot with these mason jars and stuff, and it really does get fair fuel mileage. You'll get 3 to 5 miles per gallon difference, but the technology's out there to get, you know, 100 miles, 165 miles per gallon, no doubt about it. It's there. It's just, you know, whether or not you open your eyes up and, you know, and have an open mind, you know, to see it, and be willing to make that change, you know, to think about the environment.
Open your eyes, open your mind, and make the change, right?
Right. Right. There should be a song, shouldn't it?
Yeah.
It should.
This is amazing. It's an amazing, the most amazing rat rod we've seen so far. He winces when I say rat rod.
A little bit. It tints up just a little bit. Like,
it has flat paint and it's made from parts of different cars.
It's a hot rod to me. It's a hot rod. It's what hot rodding was about. A rat
rod. A hot rat is what it is.
Now, I could live with that maybe. A hot rat. I could live with that. It's what, you know, the community was about back in the day. I mean, it was, you know, there was gangs of it almost, you know, and it was organized, you know, and it was fun. And now it's gotten to the point where Viva Las Vegas, you know, rocks, you know, I mean, things like that. Lone Star Roundup, Steve Worthermeyer, you rock.
Are you going to be here for Viva this year?
we may not have to produce all of this gas to make it work. And that's exciting to me. It's I've discovered something that it keeps me awake at night, because all of a sudden I realize that we don't have to make all this gas in order to. When I look at the tanks that they're using 5,000 pounds of pressure to get the power density into that engine and to get it to go 250 miles, until you get another fill up, I look at that and I ran across something that really excited me, is the fact that, wait a minute, we don't have to make all that gas in order to make it work. And that's what I'm working on right now. If that happens, it changes the whole equation. Absolutely whole equation.
Yeah, it sure does. And you know what's amazing to me about it is that the same liquid that the fuel is being made from is the very thing that can make that fuel go farther in an engine and actually work in an engine, but in a different form.
Yeah, exactly.
That's just,
let me give you
almost miraculous.
Let me give you a little food for thought for everybody out there. Okay, let's take some of the elements that are inside of an engine, and let's say, why can't we use these elements differently to make things a little bit better in the future? So let's take an example. If you take helium, for example, you can take four helium atoms carbon. And if you pump it into carbon, it'll become unstable. And that carbon will split. And when it splits, it's 10,000 to 1. Now, let's talk about the next step in this whole process, and let's talk about that. Think about that.
I never have.
Yeah.
I wasn't aware of that.
Yeah.
So in other words, you're saying that could be used as a fuel?
Well, of course. We've got everything in the car. We got everything available right now to put together an incredible new concept with far-reaching implications and far-reaching power than we're doing today. That's what I see. That's what I understand. And it'll be amazing.
Merch updates are ready. If you want to look good in the H2 hot rodding scene, and if you would like to pick up some hydrogen hot rodding merch, now is your chance. Please head over to our hydrogen hot rod shop. The link is in the description. Thanks. Alternatively, you can send me an email or join me on WhatsApp chat. The details are in the description. Let me know which things you like and what sizes you want. Very fast. Whether it's a roadster, supercar, or a yacht build, or maybe even an industrial power gas energy project. I'm here to assist and guide you. Please head over to the Consult with Dan link in the description, book a discussion for 10 to 30 minutes, and I will save you decades of study.